part two of debunking nutrition myths, clean eating, meal plans, and flexible dieting.
You know where I come from, day short and the night go long, yeah, I've been keeping motion. Busy girl, stay up on my own, and I know I keep you calling, even though I stay my distance, you know they say the sun.
Hey, strong friends, so this is part two of the debunking nutrition myths that we were going through. Actually, I'm kind of delayed on this, so this was like a month ago, maybe a couple months ago, but I'm finally getting around to answering these questions and making videos. So today we are talking about types of nutrition, and a lot of the questions that I got that I categorized into this section were talking about clean eating, meal plans, and flexible dieting, or IIFYM. So let's dig right in. So the topic that we're going through right now is eating clean, IIFYM, and meal plans. So Tavis asks, or he says, myth, that clean eating is key to weight loss irrespective of calorie content. So my answer, the key to weight loss for anyone is to basically be in a caloric deficit. You basically need to be consuming less calories than you are burning on a daily basis, which is how you lose weight. Now we're talking weight loss here, not fat loss. If we want to dig a little deeper into fat loss and maintaining or improving our lean mass, then the breakdown of calories are going to be important, such as flexible dieting and macronutrients. But because we're talking about clean eating here, just because you eat clean food, so example, no processed, artificial, junk food, candy, stuff like that, that doesn't mean you'll lose weight. It's all about the caloric intake, more specifically how those calories are made up. So weight loss does not matter if it is through clean eating or flexible dieting or whatever. It's calories. So if you want to call calories as calories or calories as macros, it's the same thing. Moving on. Gigi says, meal planning versus strict IIFYM. Does one yield better results than the other? To answer this question, I actually know Lauren Conlon and Dr. Bill Campbell did an awesome recent study. I think it was in 2016. And I'm just gonna very briefly go through the tests that they did and the results. And I'm going to post more info and the research below in the video notes so that you can see more details, because I don't wanna ramble on too much. So they did a 10-week study of 27 resistance trained males and females, about 25 year olds. They split them between a rigid diet or a flexible diet phase, both with a 25% decrease in calories. So the rigid macro counting group, which we are calling exclusive in this study, it included a pretty basic diet, including foods such as eggs, egg whites, protein shakes. They were given preparation instructions, oats, berries, 99% lean turkey breasts, chicken breasts, fish. They were giving specific options for the fish, brown rice, potatoes, and choices of different vegetables and oils if they needed to increase fat take. The flexible macro counting group, termed inclusive in the study, the study subjects could eat whatever they wanted as long as it fits their macros. They were given no food restrictions and could therefore incorporate more variety into their diet. They all continued on their regular training program. Nothing changed with that. Results. Both groups lost weight and body fat with no differences between groups in weight loss, body fat mass loss, and body fat percent decrease. However, in the 10 weeks post-diet, the flexible diet group gained a significant amount of fat-free mass compared to the rigid group, though there was no difference between groups in resistance or aerobic exercises. No other changes were noticed in the 10-week diet phase. Take-home message. This is part of their notes too, so I'm just reading off what they said. Does this mean that you can go gangbuster on gummy bears and donuts? Not exactly. After all, if you're cutting calories, it's pretty difficult to incorporate high-calorie foods that aren't very filling, unless you don't mind the distraction of hunger pangs later in the day. However, it does mean you can loosen up a little on rigid dieting. As stated by study author Dr. Bill Campbell, if you're the type of person that has cravings for certain foods, you might be able to consume them in limited quantities during a diet phase with a flexible dieting strategy. This is very appealing for some dieters. Others prefer to have a meal plan created for them with specific foods that they are consuming during their diets. In this case, a rigid or exclusive diet is more appealing. Keep in mind, macro counting, flexible or rigid, is a tool to get a quick end destination, shedding fat. Moving on to the next question. So I don't know her name, but it's CPA Enob. She says, is it worth the time to follow IIFYM? And Marianne says, IIFYM, a good way to eat or not at all? My opinion. It depends on your lifestyle, your goals, how serious you are on achieving your goals, and your overall level of commitment during the program. If you have the time and patience to learn how to track macros, it will absolutely get easier over time, and it will allow you to get to create the ideal body composition, so fat mass versus fat-free mass or lean mass, that you're after. If you've tried different fat diets and learned they weren't successful or that you couldn't adhere to them over an extended period of time and you aren't sure where to move next, then IIFYM would be my recommendation. If you're a businesswoman with a family at home and say you have to drive kids to soccer practice, babysitting, the mall after work, and you barely have time to brush your hair in the morning, then maybe IIFYM isn't the best practice for you at this time. But in my opinion, at the end of the day, if you're really serious about your goals and you want to be successful, having a coach guide you through the IIFYM practice and protocols is definitely the best way to reach your composition goals. Again, my opinion, this is what works for me and my clients, this is what I know. So yeah. Lindsay says, IIFYM is unhealthy compared to clean eating. So IIFYM has this bad rap that IIFYMers only eat Pop-Tarts, donuts, burgers, and tubs of ice cream. And I'm sure there are some people out there that actually do that on a daily basis, and that's great if it works for them. Everyone's going to be different, and some people can wake up and crush a burger and still feel great. But over time, as I've learned, that if you eat like crap, you're going to feel like crap, and you're going to perform like crap. I would say the majority of IIFYMers follow about a 70 to 30 approach, so 70% good, healthy, nutritious, and clean foods, so like veggies, meats, beans, nuts, seeds, etc., and about 30% junk food. Personally, I think that clean eating can be unhealthy if it's associated with a clean eating disorder called orthorexia nervosa, and I'm totally preaching, I'll get into this later, but I was totally in that mindset before, that like clean eating was the only way to go, you get obsessive about it, and yeah, it can be unhealthy. And that's where people are obsessed about eating clean foods. Okay, moving on to Ashley's question. How much sodium is too much? My answer. Sodium is an essential nutrient found in salt and many foods. Our bodies need a small amount of sodium to be healthy, but too much can lead to high blood pressure, a major risk factor for stroke, heart disease, and kidney disease. Sodium intake has also been linked to an increased risk of osteoporosis, stomach cancer, and severity of asthma. The average Canadian consumes almost double the recommended daily intake, and according to American Health Association and Health Canada, it's recommended to stay under about 23,000 milligrams a day. Some people can build up higher tolerances than others. It's like anything. It's like people that eat way more macros than other people, right? You can build up your tolerance. You can drink more water than other people. I know some people that actually hit 20,000 milligrams of sodium a day. There was one point I was eating 13,000 milligrams a day. Now, it wasn't the best for me, and I had to change that, but you can. So it just depends on the person. But the higher your sodium intake, the thirstier you'll be, and then you'll probably end up retaining more water in your body. You'll find high sodium levels in food products like breads, processed meats, vegetable-based dishes, and vegetable juices and soups. So how much sodium is too much? It depends on your body, but when I recommend to clients, I usually try to stay under the 3,000 range just to be sure. But I have some clients, we do track sodium levels, and some people it doesn't matter, some people it does. So again, everybody's different. Last question by Haley. She says, over-consuming processed foods. And that's all she says. So I'm going to dig in a little bit, interpret that on my own, and this is my answer. Processed foods are usually high in refined carbs and low in nutritional value. Overconsumption of refined carbs is associated with many health effects and chronic diseases. They can lead to rapid blood sugar spikes and insulin levels. Not getting enough nutrients from your food can make you feel tired and sluggish, causing poor performance. If you're following an IIFYM approach and want to consume processed foods about 30% of the time, I don't see that being an issue. Again, it depends on the person, how their body handles the food intake, and how it feels, how they feel, and it affects their mood and performance. So that is my part two. I don't know why I do that. Part two of Nutrition Myths Debunked, talking about IIFYM, flexible dieting, clean eating. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, send me a message. Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe below. Comment below if you have any questions, if there's anything flexible dieting or food-based, nutrition-based that you have a question about. Send me a message. I want to know. You can email me, courtney.yu@live.ca. If you're interested in working with me on flexible dieting and coaching, you can visit my website, courtneyforlife.com/coaching, and you can see all the programs that I offer. Thank you again for watching. I hope you have a lovely afternoon, and we will talk later. Bye, guys.